All right, allegedly we're live. Don't like how many dropped frames I'm already showing in OBS. I don't know what that's about, but see how bad it gets. We're in Portland here at the terminal, hauling some gasoline to a truck stop in Ontario. Got the Project 3XX obviously with my truck and trailer mod. This is a local company. They also have a couple divisions in California as well. Superior Tank Lines. Thought it was a neat skin, so I made it. It's included with the mod. I actually saw one of their trucks, a newer 567, 3 or 4 weeks ago in Portland. So. Get our track IR centered here. The lift axle down. And after Ontario, I'm not sure where we're going to go. We might head down to Winnemucca or Austin, Nevada, I think it is. There's a couple places we can haul out of there. Like we're waiting for a max to go by there. Yep. But we're a tanker, so we stop at all railroad crossings. Before we stop. Once again, I'm running the Maxi Cruise engine. Something a little different. Think it sounds pretty cool. Jake is from the Cummins X15 in the W990 mod. I saw this truck, one of these trucks, a couple weeks ago. It's right down here off of I-84 where we're going right now. Delivering at a gas station in Fairview. in real life, this goes through a tunnel here, and it goes down to one lane before it meets up with 84 here. So it would have been right in this area before you get to Troutdale, which is what this place is right here. That light. Can't see it because it's turned sideways, but got Baby Yoda chilling with me. SES would fix that. $105,000, right where we should be. Hey Jeff. Missed that one pretty bad. Go up the mountains behind this guy just to demonstrate how little power the AI trucks have. Oh, thanks. I'm not sure if you were watching when I said what it was, but it's the Mac Maxi Cruise from the, I think it was the Mac Anthem, I want to say. But you know, for a modern kind of engine sound, I think it sounds pretty cool. And the Jake is from the X15 and the W990. Speeding quite a bit here. Falls Dam. I don't know if they do tours of that dam, but I'd love to get a tour on it. They don't have the Bonneville Dam modeled, which is the last dam on the Columbia, so it's back the way we came from this one. But I've been on, you know, multiple tours of the Bonneville Dam since I was a kid. Coming up on Biggs Junction here. Might grab some fuel. As a kid, I'd go to Idaho with a friend of mine a few times, and on our way back, we'd always stop here at Biggs at the truck stop and have lunch, and they had some 1/32nd scale die-cast trucks. We started a kind of a die-cast truck collection out of them. Yeah, it's the first engine sound that I really like besides the N14. The 444 is pretty cool too, but I'm just kind of stuck with that N14 for so long. It's glad I found something else I really like. It did take me a while to figure it out, though. It was that stupid thing where you have to give it a unique ID in the engine def file. For whatever reason, it didn't occur to me that I had to do that to make it work. Like all the other parts you make, you have to have that unique ID thing in there, or name, or whatever you call it. I don't like that little chirpy air brake sound. I want to change that. I don't know if anybody realizes it, but there's a little hidden road back this way I'll show you guys. I don't know why they put the refueling icons in the middle of the pumps. It looks kind of weird. Gotta park between them, but what do I know? Lately, I'm really digging this kind of just plain mesh grill. I guess it's kind of a slatted mesh. It's kind of interesting. That and the single headlights. So there's a little hidden road back here that just loops around. Yeah, it was pretty awesome once they finally added Oregon and Washington, that I've been able to drive places I've actually been. Gonna take quite a while to get out your way, Jeff. But I imagine those tight New England roads would be pretty fun too. I don't imagine I'll enjoy the Midwest very much. So yeah, just this little gravel road that comes under the bridge up here. I'm really curious what FMOD is going to bring and how difficult it's going to be to port these old sound mods to work with it. Everybody's wondering about all the grinding I do drive advanced mode or advanced shifting. Yeah, one of the spots we're kind of missing, I think it's up ahead. It's represented somewhat. The town of Arlington. In real life, the freeway makes a big downhill dip into the town. Yeah, it's represented right up here by that kind of that green elevator. But in real life, the freeway takes a big dip down into the town, and then big hill coming back out. Yeah, I'll cheat a little bit with the clutch here and there if I have to, but generally avoid it unless I really get screwed up. Yeah, there's this cool little town kind of right on our right here in real life, and there's an old railroad caboose they got sitting out that you can kind of go visit, and just this little kind of hole in the wall place. Dad drove, he said it was always fun pulling out of Arlington onto the freeway, heading up this huge long ramp uphill to get back onto the freeway and trying to merge with everyone. I think I'm running 373 gears in this truck. A little more freeway friendly. I normally run 410s. Yeah, just really curious what it's going to take, how difficult that's going to be with that sound mod. It's probably not too horrible, but I assume it's a bunch of differences in the deaf side of things, how it defines how the sounds are used. So I really have very little experience in that area anyways with the sounds, so I'm excited at the possibilities. You know, they've just showed that teaser with the window down and how that's going to work with being able to roll the window down and getting like more and more outside noise as you do it. I would like, you know, railroad crossings that have, you know, bells and all that. There was something else I was kind of excited for, like, I like better Doppler effects. I don't think, are there any Doppler effects right now? Doesn't really sound like it. This area has experienced a lot of flooding in the last couple weeks. Yeah, I imagine the animations aren't going to be fun to actually implement. One of the things I would love to figure out would be to make that swing plate on the bumper swing back and forth. The only person I think I've ever seen do outside animations is John Ruta had a video on his channel like antennas and like mud flaps swinging. So I imagine it'd be very similar to that. I just have no idea how to do it. This is called Cabbage Hill here, coming out of Pendleton. I don't know why, in real life, there's a truck stop right at the bottom of the hill that they didn't put in here. But unfortunately, it's just not very steep in the game. Like, I can cruise up here in 7th and 8th pretty much the whole way. Yeah, tunnels, that was the other thing. For sure. Trying to think of the mountains we're in. I think this is the blue mountain range or something like that. Unfortunately, I haven't actually driven out this way in over 10 years. I drove to Yellowstone. I do have this mod installed that makes the signs for the construction zones set back a lot farther, so you get way more warning. And it makes the construction zones bigger as well. I traffic on my left. I do have some new switches for my button box that I want to get installed. Like a proper toggle for the Jake instead of a rocker switch. I've just been kind of lazy about it. That and I got a push-pull switch as well for the parking brake. I guess we gotta face the other way. Figure out where do we want to go next. We can either go to Austin and haul some stuff out of there, or back to Portland, which is probably a shorter trip. But I don't know, I think we'll have some more interesting routes if we go to Austin to get some our next load. That's kind of the reality when you drive a fuel tankers. You don't haul anything coming back. You just deliver your fuel and then you head empty to your next loading area. It doesn't look like I've dropped any more frames than what I did when I just had the stream in preview mode, so that's good. So right here is a, I think it's cement. In real life, this is or was owned by Ashland. And you can't miss it when you drive by. It's this huge plant. And when I was a kid, one of my friend's stepfathers actually worked for Ashland. Not that particular plant, but it's cool that it's there in the game. Excuse me while I... Oh, shit. You gotta be kidding me. I have this problem where randomly the game minimizes itself. So I just did that for no reason. Happens a couple times a week. So that's lovely. Anyways, what I was gonna say is, excuse me while I text a little bit. Drive. Can't believe I caught that gear, and then I missed the next one. Anyway, someone just commented on the post. Apparently, it sounds like they probably live in California. So they said they see the Superior trucks all the time down there. So that's pretty cool. Do I use a graphic mod? Yes, I'm using the JBX Graphics 2. It's the payware mod where it's both the JBX settings and then it's a graphical mod to the game itself, as well as, you know, the skyboxes and everything. I think it was $9 or $10 or something. I really like the look of it. Of course, right now the skyboxes matter because there's no clouds, but. Welcome to Eastern Oregon. Got about 400 miles to get to Austin. And you'll see part of the Sierra Nevada mod when we get there as well. I don't know how much time we're gonna drive in the Sierra Nevada area of the map, but it'd be cool if we got some destinations in there. Welcome to Idaho, where the speed limit goes up as soon as you get in. Things I'd like to do is eventually figure out texturing more and UV mapping and all that. In real life, the Superior trucks have a big Superior logo on the back of the trailer. Yeah, I'm curious to see how they pull off Idaho, especially up in the panhandle where it's so narrow with the scaling issues we have already, and how that's gonna work out. I'd like to get to the bottom of why the game minimizes itself randomly. That only started a couple months ago. And now we got some cool skyboxes going. Maybe after I do the next tanker load, we'll drive a different truck. Seems like I switch between trucks every couple loads because I just don't want to say I get bored, but I just have so many to choose from, it's hard to pick one. Things I added in my last update were these turn signals on the fenders. It's not the greatest modeling, obviously, but they get the job done. There's a lot in real life, a lot of these trucks have a turn signal mounted there. Things I've never paid attention to is whether fuel in these rural areas is more expensive than in the cities in the game. Let's see if we can pull off a pass here in the passing zone. Nailed it. say I've been using this Thrustmaster T300 now for 2 or 3 months and really liking it. Still just as good as when I got it. Sweet. Glad I can bypass this way station because it's kind of a pain in the ass. Especially if you're coming from that direction. And you're trying to go this direction. Maybe I'll drive my Wood Feathers truck, the one that I built based off my dad's old truck. I don't think I've done any videos or streams of that since the first one I did a few months ago. That one's still a lot of fun. Limited cargoes, though. It only has the wood shakes and the shingles cargoes, so. Which is intentional, because that's all the truck hauled in real life, so. I think it would look kind of weird with a roofing company skin hauling, you know, steel or something. I don't know if these night skies, if that's part of the mod or not. I honestly don't drive at night enough to remember what either the stock skies or the mod skies look like, so. Looks like we've hit Nevada. I think we're coming into Winnemucca right now. We're close to it. Let me stop and check the map real quick and see. Yeah, we'll grab fuel as we're going through Winnemucca right there. It'd be a good spot to get it. I want to say that looks pretty much like the stock sky. Yeah, so you can see that sign there. We're heading into the part of the map that the Sierra Nevada mod redid. So this town of Austin we're going to was a town that was added by the Sierra Nevada mod. Let's get our pass on here. almost made the made it before the no passing zone. I did mod the flares in these air cleaner lights. By default, they're like, I don't know that much about modding those, but they're just like little LEDs that you only really see from the front. I changed them to be kind of more normal lights so you can kind of see them from the side. Crap where the AI stops like that. I don't put up with it. And then they stop on the exit here too. At least they often do. Yeah, like that guy just stopped or slowed way down. Hopefully some AI improvements are coming this year as well with everything else, because it just drives me batshit crazy sometimes. So one thing a lot of people don't know is you can mod the interior cameras to increase the draw distance. So a lot of people complain about the draw distance in the game being really short, which it is. Not something that can be set in the interior camera. Unfortunately, I can't remember the name of the parameter that it is, but the default parameter is like 1600 meters, and I just added 1000 to it, and it seems to work a lot better. Really good, especially for map mods. That don't have as many tricks as the default maps for hiding things in the distance, basically. Might as well head up the truck shop up here too and fix some of that damage that was caused when we alt-tabbed right into a Jersey barrier. Thank you. watch the parked cars there. Children. Let's see here, was there anything on the truck I wanted to change? Been pretty happy with how I got it set up right now. Yeah, I can't really think of anything that I missed when I set this up recently, so. I'm gonna go ahead and advance time while we're here. Driving a while. Yeah, it's the best way to get out of this dump. Yeah, one of the things I added a while back was a different views out the back window depending on your truck configuration, and it's controlled by the airline or the trailer cable hookup. So whatever you have that set to is what it shows out the back window. That was the easiest way I could think to do that. Oh, I meant to stop here and get fuel. I'm all distracted. So this is all part of the Sierra Nevada mod here. Yeah, it's kind of hard to get a grasp on the whole area that the Sierra Nevada mod redoes, but it's basically this whole kind of circle here. It's quite a bit larger than I expected. Still haven't dropped a single frame since I was doing my preview before the live stream started, so that's good. Oops. Pay attention. Doesn't feel like I've been going for an hour. Just about to pass this guy, but I realize I gotta exit up here. Stop at all railroad crossings. Yeah, this train coming anyways. This be a modded train. I've got a train mod that makes trains bigger, which is nice. Not super realistic to have intermodal stuff dispersed in a manifest train, but still cool to see bigger trains. Correctly, this kind of turns into a gravel road or a dirt road. pipeline deal going on there. Quite a ways back in here to get to this damn plant. That's right. I've driven through here, but I've never been to the plant. Come down in this quarry thing here. This is always kind of a cool prefab. Huh, I guess you can drive up that way. Bummer, I was kind of hoping for a Sierra Nevada destination somewhere in these three cities. Just for giggles, let's go to the next day, see if we can get anything. Cool, Carson, that works. Short trip to a scenic place. This is kind of cool because it's like a real kind of tank filling station. Just pull through. So we're going to continue on that dirt road for a while until we get back to Highway 50. Let's take a quick look at this right here. I don't know where the hell this goes. Nowhere really, I guess. I kind of wonder if it's possible if I can just kind of drive up right out the dirt here. Oops, I was rolling there. There's not an invisible wall right here. this portion of the road is definitely rougher than the first half. Should probably slow down a little. Cloud pattern. I think we're getting pretty close to the pavement. Starting to see some of the cool mountains in the Sierra Nevadas. See, the draw distance is kind of weird with the your head rotation. Played more than one game that does that. Mirror, you can kind of see the streaking in the skybox. That's both a combination of the Sierra Nevada mod and the graphics mod doing that. You typically won't see that in any of the stock areas of the map. And that's because the draw distance in the mirrors is less than the normal draw distance of the windows. So the scenery that would be blocking that streaking is not there. You'll see it sometimes normally out the windows depending on where you're at too. I can't believe I have an AI truck actually stuck behind me. Normally I blow their doors off. Properly. Which is kind of a bummer. As it draws in there, it kind of helps it. I've always wanted to drive Highway 50. Years ago, the Top Gear guys did a whole episode where they drove across Highway 50 in Nevada in American muscle cars. I think it's dubbed the loneliest highway in America. Carson City, where we're headed, is one of my favorites now in this Sierra Nevada mod, as far as cities go. How the AI traffic isn't using the turn lane that they have. 5 miles. Bit of Z clipping through there. Not sure what that's about. Definitely lost some frames as we came into town here. Excuse me for 1 second, I have to go open the garage door. Alright, I'm back. Alright, let's just park it in the little cover here. So we'll come around so we're not doing it blindside. axle up. I'm used to overshooting, so I try to cut tight, and then of course I'm too damn tight. I suspect I'm not overshooting, but this will find out. Yep, I overshot. Alright, let's drive this bad boy. I haven't driven in a while. Don't think there was anything I needed to do to it. Yeah, there's been a bunch of changes to this truck since I showed it on the channel a few months ago. Changed up the load to be more realistic with how many pallets are on the truck and the trailer and their placement. Set up the fuel tank on the driver's side wasn't actually a step tank. It had the tank mounted in the normal spot behind the cab with a normal step there. On the passenger side is a step tank. Shown this to my dad, and he kind of pointed out the few little things I had wrong with it, so it's pretty cool. Got the spare tire mounted to the trailer there. See, I don't have a flatbed modeled out of the back of the window on this truck. It's because I never got around to it, since it's not a flatbed truck. Nor do I have the headache rack with the window in it either, like, oh shit. I just realized this truck's missing its mud flaps again. That's a mod conflict I have between this truck and the public truck mod. So it causes this truck to lose the mud flaps. Something I gotta address and fix. Actually, they disappeared after I went to the shop. I shouldn't have gone to the shop. So this plant up here in Tacoma is one of the places where my dad would often drive this truck and pick up roofing material to bring back to the warehouse in Vancouver. And then Newport, where we're going, is one of the places he delivered to, not super often. Yeah, so I just backed out there and changed the mod order so I can get the mud flaps back. Alright, let's try it now. There we go. Double check our gearing here. Yeah, I want to put the 410s back in it. Jake switch again. I do that constantly. See, I added some rolls of felt to the load since I was off of hold as well. The felt goes, if anyone doesn't know, it goes underneath the shingles. I believe it's the first layer that gets put on over the plywood on your roof. I think I'm going to go down through Astoria. Why that guy stopped so far out there. I wasn't paying attention when that happened. Yeah, we'll hit the rest stop somewhere around milepost. I think it's like 58 or 65, something like that. Advance time till daytime. in with just the mirror. Done better, done worse. I didn't mean to actually use the in-game sleep function, but that worked. One of the other things I did was I got rid of the rub rails on the truck and the trailer. Since his truck didn't have rub rails. And I got rid of the marker lights kind of down the middle of the truck and the trailer beds. So it didn't have those either. Cool sunrise. Hit the scale real quick and see where we're at. Should be about 88,000 or so. Looks like I did drop a few more frames at one point, but still only 0.1%. bad we don't have the grade on Highway 30 coming up out of Rainier like there is in real life right here. Astoria trolley. So a list of movies off the top of my head that have filmed either partially or quite a bit in Astoria. It's obviously The Goonies, which I've never really cared much for that movie, but Kindergarten Cop, Arnold Schwarzenegger, Short Circuit, and Free Willy. The last three movies there were movies I loved as a kid. This bridge is 4 miles long across the mouth of the Columbia. This is the Warrington Bridge. And there's actually a little Easter egg. You see that? Oh yeah, you see the orca jump right there? And the kid standing out on the rocks. So that's a Free Willy Easter egg that the devs put in there. I haven't spotted any Goonies or Short Circuit or Kindergarten Cop Easter eggs. It's horrible sometimes. Almost there. Just a Toledo, Ohio, but there's a Toledo, Oregon, and a Toledo, Washington. Take it. Alright, well, I think that's going to be the stream, so thanks for watching, everybody.